Good morning! So today I have with me four different types of dry leaves. All of them are supposed to be good for your betta fish, so I'm going to add them to my betta's waters and see which ones are best. So this is the water before adding anything, one day after changing the water. As you can see, the pH is 7.4. I've got some bay cedar. So in Indonesian it's called jati blanda. I've got drain net and I'm just gonna stuff this in. As for the bay cedar, as you can see, it doesn't seem to have any immediate reaction. Alright, next in line we have an aquarist's favorite, Indian almond leaves, also known as sea almond leaves, Terminalia catapa. Okay, now I'm just going to drop this in. Everyone should be familiar with the effects that Terminalia catapa has, or sea almond leaves have. It's gonna turn the water light yellow, take some time. Well, this is ugly. Well, never mind that. These are banana leaves, another popular option. I'm just gonna shred them up. Or just crunch them up. Should be enough, and I'm going to now stuff them. Okay, that looks like just a little bit too little. There we go. I suck at tying stuff. Okay, oops, watch out there, buddy. Incoming. Okay, and now last but not least, I've actually tried these leaves before. These are palm leaflets from the palm fronds outside of my house. Pretty effective. So I'm just gonna do the same thing as before. Tie them up. All that's left to do is to drop it in. Okay, so now that everything's added in, I'm gonna leave them for 5 days. I'm gonna be watching out for any signs of lethargy or its opposite, hyperactiveness. Thank you. Bye.